Stephanie Flanders, you're chief market strategist at UK and Europe at JP Morgan. Now, Italy is in recession, France is in trouble, and crisis looms elsewhere. How safe is Europe?
Well, I think, I guess it depends on whether you're talking about safe from an investor standpoint or safe from a sort of long-term economic standpoint. I think the recovery in economic terms is moving ahead, but much more slowly than we would like. And I think the risk that there will be problems with deflation or a long period of very low inflation is greater now than it was at the start of the year, and that's obviously why the European Central Bank has acted. But as investors, I think people could look to European markets and still see some reason for optimism, partly because the European Central Bank has committed to continue this policy of cheap money, of great liquidity, at a time when the US, for example, may be raising interest rates. And I think also because we can see that even the improvement in the economy that we've seen so far, though it hasn't been as great as we would like, even that should translate into rising corporate earnings. And we have said for a long time that we think it's now earnings, corporate earnings, that should support European equities from here.
Was the ECB right to lower the interest rates to almost zero?
I think obviously the interest rate move sent a particular signal, but when you're starting already at such a low level, I think the marginal impact of this cut would probably be not very significant. But clearly, at the same meeting, the other decisions that were announced to start purchasing asset-backed securities and the other measures and the commitment to try and increase the size of the European Central Bank's balance sheet back to where it was a couple of years ago, I think that did send an important message to markets that the European Central Bank is going to do its part to try and keep the recovery going. The question I have, the question I'm sure Mario Draghi has, is are governments going to do their part? Because these measures by themselves will not support long-term growth without structural reforms, particularly in countries like Italy.
Now, going to the English-speaking countries, who do you think will raise the interest rates first, the BOE or the Federal Reserve?
Well, the markets have been betting for quite a long time that the Bank of England would raise rates first, and I think I'd probably still go with that bet. But clearly, expectations have been rising that the Federal Reserve will also be raising rates in the first half of next year. I think we're moving to that, but I suspect that if I understand the way that Janet Yellen is looking at the world and looking at the markets, I think that they will be maybe a little more dovish than the markets expect. They will move maybe a bit more slowly than the markets might expect, just looking at the economic data. Whereas the Bank of England, the data in the UK has been so strong that even with very weak growth in wages, in average earnings, I think they will still feel that they have to raise rates in the first part of next year. The betting at the moment is February.
If the BOE goes first, what would be the impact on the world market?
Well, I think it's an interesting question that there are all these central banks who are positioning themselves to raise rates after this very long period where they've all been at rock bottom. And some have compared it to a group of cyclists where you don't want to be right at the front because you get all of the wind on you and the others are sort of sheltering in your shadow. And I think that will be one of the problems for the Bank of England. If it goes first, will it maybe struggle with pressure on its currency and have those kind of headwinds on its economy? So I suspect we'll see central banks maybe moving together more than their economies are moving together because of that dynamic.
Let me finish with the personal questions. You were an economics editor at the BBC. Now you work at JP Morgan. How's your journey in the financial world been so far?
It's been fascinating. I'm sure lots of people think that they should have a change in their jobs after 10 years. I was at the BBC for more than 10 years and I'd worked in public policy before that. I guess I'm someone who always wants to try something new, and I hadn't been in a big private institution before. And JP Morgan, not to sound too much like a commercial, but we are involved in so many different parts of the global financial system. For me, it's been a wonderful education, and it's still pretty exciting.
And you can be a bit more biased when you speak out on the financial
market. I am allowed to have opinions. That is very nice. I can have opinions, and I can plan. Well, I can have a little more chance of planning my evenings rather than always wondering whether I'm on the 10 o'clock news. My children like that very much.
Stephanie Flanders, very much for that review.
Thank you.